So, this video we're going to talk a little bit about what is logic in general, just a little introduction to the topic for those people who aren't really familiar with what's to come. So philosophers have defined logic in a lot of different ways over the years. Some people have called it the science of thinking. Others think about it as the study of good reasoning practices or something. These can be useful definitions. When we think of logical thinking intuitively, you might think of characters like Spock from Star Trek or Sherlock Holmes, people like that. So what makes those characters interesting, or what especially logical about them? Seems to be their ability to draw inferences from small amounts of evidence. So, you know, Sherlock Holmes can look at a shoelace left on the ground and draw a whole chain of inferences that leads him back to the murderer. So, yeah, intuitively that maybe is what we think of logic. It can be a very difficult topic, so to keep things simple in this course, we'll understand logic to be simply the study of arguments. But we mean something a little bit special by an argument. What is an argument? Well, normally when you think of an argument, you might think of two people shouting at each other angrily. Right? Someone steps on the other person's foot or something, and they get into a shouting match, calling each other names and so on. That might be what you think of as an argument, like a fight. But that's not what we have in mind in this class. In logic, an argument is more like an argument that an attorney makes to prove that the defendant could not have been at the crime scene at the time of the murder. So what's going on there? Well, the attorney is trying to convince the jury that something is true, that the defender is innocent. And he's trying to do that by giving them reasons that persuade them to accept that conclusion. So in the simplest terms, then, an argument is basically a series of sentences which is supposed to provide reasons for accepting some statement known as a conclusion as being true. Okay, so pretty basic, nothing overly fancy or sophisticated here, but by keeping it kind of simple and focused on the practical side of logic, which is analyzing arguments, hopefully you'll have a little bit of an easier time getting a grip on the material. So, just to give you a little flavor of what we're going to be investigating, it's pretty obvious that intuitively some arguments are better than others. Right, so if we look at the first argument here, suppose Alice is trying to convince her friend that it's not going to rain. And she says in the first argument, it's not going to rain, I'm going to a barbecue later. Well, this is not a very good argument. Right? The fact that Alice is going to a barbecue outside, which presumably would be ruined by the rain, doesn't mean that it's not going to rain. The weather doesn't pay attention to our social plans, as anyone knows who's planned an outdoor event. So this is more like wishful thinking on the part of Alice. It's not really a good persuasive argument. Right, so look at the second case. Same conclusion that Alice is going for. It's not going to rain. The skies are totally clear, and the weather report predicted sun. So in this case, this seems like a much more persuasive argument because the reasons that Alice is given are actually good evidence that it's not going to rain. Whereas the fact that she's going to a barbecue and maybe doesn't want it to rain isn't good evidence. Okay, so we're starting to get into the sense that there's intuitively we can recognize good ways of arguing and bad ways of arguing. So in this class, we're going to be making those intuitions really precise, in some cases formalizing them. And so we have, more formal machinery to make those judgments of whether an argument is good or bad. Now, one difficulty is that in English, English can be a bit messy when you're trying to do logic. Right, for one thing, there's a lot of different ways to say the same thing. So look at these three sentences. It's raining. There's rain falling from the sky. Water's descending from the clouds in droplets. Obviously, these have different, maybe, connotations, but ultimately they're conveying the same information, basically that it's raining, and some saying it in a more convoluted way. So As if, you know, you're making an argument and part of your evidence is that it's raining, part of the reason that you're giving for your argument is that it's raining, it shouldn't really matter whether you, you know, use flowery language or complicated language like in the third bullet point as compared to the first bullet point. What matters is the information that's being conveyed. So in that sense, that's one reason why we, when we're studying logic, we're going to use symbols to represent these pieces of information or these sentences rather than the English sentence itself, because that allows us to consider these three sentences as basically expressing the same thing. So that's one reason why we'll be using symbolic notation in the future. So basically, logic is the study of arguments. It involves analyzing arguments, understanding their structure, and evaluating whether they're good or bad. And generally, this is done by translating the arguments into symbolic notation and then using formal machinery to evaluate them.